Is my chat history saved somewhere? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question. If I disable my chat history in the app I use, is it guaranteed that the conversations are not stored somewhere else? Guaranteed? Certainly not. In fact, there are several ways that your chat history could still be getting saved in different places. It's unlikely, but it's absolutely possible. The number one risk that I've seen over the years is not based in technology. It's based on who you're chatting with. Remember that they too can see the chat. That by definition is what chats are all about. And if you trust them, well, maybe it's not an issue. But remember, they can keep a history of your chat. That could come back to bite you or not. So the number one risk, make sure you trust whomever it is you're chatting with and/or make sure you're chatting about appropriate topics. In other words, you're not sharing things you wouldn't share with someone that you don't trust appropriately. So number one, the other guy. Number two, the chat tool itself. And there are a lot of different tools around for chatting. And I'm talking about things like WhatsApp, Facebook Messenger, Signal, Telegram, and many, many more. Some of them pride themselves on security and privacy. Signal comes to mind. Some of them will say that they respect your privacy and security and even have encrypted end-to-end chats, but they come from companies that we don't necessarily trust. I'm thinking of WhatsApp and Facebook Messenger, both of whom come from Facebook/Meta. End-to-end encryption is in fact the buzzword. It's the appropriate buzzword to look for because by definition, if your encryption is truly end-to-end, in other words, it's encrypted before it leaves your device and it's only decrypted on the recipient's device, then there's nobody in the middle that can see what's being chatted about. However, two things. One, the service is still in the middle. And in theory, they could set things up so that it's encrypted from you to the service where it's decrypted, perhaps logged, probably not, but perhaps re-encrypted and then sent on to the recipient. Ultimately, it's very difficult to understand whether or not that's really happening. And I do have to throw out that there is a legal move afoot in some countries to require that be the architecture, because there are governments that specifically want to require the ability to monitor your chats. And ultimately, this encrypting to the service in the middle is probably the only way that that's really going to happen. That's why services like Signal exist, because they claim to do complete end-to-end encryption that cannot be monitored anywhere in transit. But that brings up another interesting point. The devices involved, whether it's a mobile device or your computer or a tablet or something else, whatever device you happen to have your chat software installed on, is at risk of malware. Specifically, things like keyloggers are probably the most obvious, but the bottom line is if you have malware on your machine or if the person you're chatting with has malware on their machine, then all bets are off. That malware could indeed be recording what's going on. Remember, it's malware. It's seeing things either before they get encrypted or after they get decrypted because it has to be visible to you. If it's visible to you on the device, it's visible to malware. So the bottom line there, of course, is make sure that you trust the technical proficiency of whomever you're chatting with and that you have your own devices appropriately secured and free of malware. And finally, and this is an incredibly tiny risk, but In Windows specifically, and I presume other operating systems as well, the chat tools use RAM. In Windows, RAM can get swapped to disk. In other words, it can get written to the paging file. There are very obscure and highly unlikely scenarios where somebody could have a look at the contents of the paging file and maybe discover chats or portions of the chat. Like I said, it's highly unlikely and typically only worth it if you are what we would consider to be a high-value target. For the most part, you and I are not high-value targets. In fact, you and I just aren't that interesting. The only time where this really does become important goes back to that number one risk, the person at the other end. I have heard of scams and other activities that basically boil down to somebody contacting you who is not who they say they are, enticing you into the chat, recording that chat, and then holding whatever that chat contains over your head with the threat of blackmail. So, chat with people you trust, use tools you trust, and make sure that your devices are free of malware. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/2544. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.